Scikit-learn is an open source machine learning library for Python. It's a very extensive library. Here we'll only make use of its KNN classifier, but there is much, much more there to explore. We'll be applying both the scikit-learn and our homemade classifier to a classic dataset created by Ron Fisher in 1933. It consists of 150 different iris flowers, 50 from each of three different species. For each flower, we have the following covariates: sepal length, sepal width, petal length, and petal width. Let's first import some datasets. From scikit-learn sklearn, import datasets. We can then extract the iris dataset, iris equals datasets.load iris, and we can run this. Let's take a look at the data. We can do this by typing iris data, and we can see 150 rows because we have 150 observations, and we have four different covariates, which is why we have four columns in our data set. For simplicity, we'll just look at the first two covariates or predictors in our example. We'll define predictors as a subset of our iris data. We would like to have all of the rows, but only columns 0 and 1. To do that, we specify 0 colon 2, because remember, the end index 2 will not be included in the slice. We'll then build an outcomes vector, which is iris.target, and we can run these two lines. Let's then try plotting our data. We'll first plot our predictors such that outcomes is equal to 0. And here we would like to have all of the rows from column 0. For y coordinates, we want the same exact thing, except we would like to have the values from column 1. And we'll be using red circles for this plot. This covers the data points that come from class 0, for which the outcomes variable is equal to 0. We can have the second line modified from the first by changing the outcomes, and we want to change the color to green. We can similarly plot observation from the third group. We just change outcomes equal to 2, and again, we want to change the color. We can go with blue in this case. We can save this data, the figure, as iris.pdf. And we can take a look at the plot. So we have observations from three different groups represented by the dots that are colored in green, blue, and red. X-axis and y-axis correspond to the values of our predictors. Let's then make a prediction grid plot. To do this, I'll be using code that I wrote previously. In this case, I want to use k equal 5. I'll call this plot irisgrid.pdf. I want to change the limits from 4 to 8. For x-axis, and from 1.5 to 4.5 for the y-axis. And we will continue to go in increments of 0.1. We can then run this code, and this is our iris prediction grid. In this case, we can see that the grid consists of three different colors because we have three different classes of observations. Looking at this grid, if we were to observe a new data point that sits somewhere in the upper left corner, this classifier would predict that observation to belong to the red class. Similarly, if we had a new observation that happened to sit in the lower left corner of the plot, that would be classified as a blue dot. Finally, if we had new observations for which the x-coordinate is very close to the right boundary of our region here, those points would be classified as belonging to the green category or class. Let's then fit the KNN classifier using both the algorithm from scikit-learn as well as our own homemade algorithm. We'll be importing the k-neighbors classifier from the sklearn neighbors module. We can run this line. Then we say knn equals k-neighbors classifier, and the number of neighbors, n neighbors, we'll set that to be equal to 5. We can run this line as well. Then we'll fit our model using the fit method. As input, we need to provide our predictors and our outcomes. Finally, we can do the predictions. We'll call these SK predictions. We'll obtain the predictions using the KNN predict function. And as input, we need to provide our predictors. We can run all of the four lines. So let's look at SK predictions. Look at the shape. We have 150 observations in this array. This makes sense. We started with 150 observations belonging to one of the three different classes. If we look at the, say, first 10 data points here, these correspond to the predictions provided by the scikit-learn algorithm using k-nearest neighbors. Let's build an array that consists of my predictions. We'll construct this as a numpy array, and we'll be building that as a list comprehension. We call the knn predict function. We provide p predictors, outcomes, and the value of k as input. We'll be looping over all of our predictors, so we type for p in predictors. We can try running this. So my predictions is a 150 element long array. Now these are the predictions that our own homemade KNN algorithm did. What we would like to do is compare the predictions obtained by the scikit library to our own homemade predictions. To do this, we can ask how often do the scikit predictions agree with my predictions. If we run this, we'll see that it's a Boolean array that consists of true and false. We can take the mean of this, in which case true will be evaluated as 1 and false will be evaluated as 0. And we can multiply this by 100 to get the percentages. Finally, let's print this entity. In this case, we see that my predictions and the scikit predictions agree 96% of the time. We can also ask how frequently do my predictions and scikit predictions agree with the actual observed outcomes. We can take the line that we have already here, and we're asking when is SK predictions equal to outcomes? And we can also ask how frequently is my predictions equal to outcomes? Let's modify the code slightly. And we run these two lines. What we see is the following. Using scikit, the actual observed outcomes for the data points that we have observed agree with the predictions of the scikit library 83% of the time. In this case, our homemade predictor is actually somewhat better. We're correct approximately 85% of the time. That's it. We did a lot in this case study. The follow-up exercises that we have prepared for you will enable you to get some more practice on classification using KNN. I hope you'll enjoy them.